Teachers can change lives with just the right amount of chalk and challenges. Now, I request Dr. J.G. Aldrich-Jovan,
Associate Professor, to introduce our chief guest to the gathering.
Thank you, Tejaswini, for giving me to introduce the chief guest of the gathering. He is not only a good researcher, but also a friend of mine right from my school ages. Really feeling privileged to introduce Dr. Ferdinand John, who is currently an assistant professor with the Faculty of Information Technology, Thai Nchi Institute of Technology, Bangkok. He graduated his bachelor's and master's in computer science and engineering from Anna University, Chennai during 2009 and respectively. He got his PhD in information systems from the National Institute of. His area of research includes deep learning, IoT, and blockchain technology. He has nearly a decade experience in teaching. He has published in peer-reviewed international conferences and journals. He is certified as the most valuable professional, MVP, with Alibaba Cloud since 2021. And I am really glad to hear his presentation today. I hope this would kindle the research environment in our institution and help us in a lot of collaborations. The stage is yours, Ferdinand. Thank you.
Thank you. So, let me share the screen. Okay, so very good evening to everyone. So hope all of you are staying safe from COVID.
Good evening, sir.
So hope my talk is quite slow enough for you to understand. So I will start right from the fundamentals. So today I'm going to talk about transformers. As we all know about the deep learning, it's like everyone is going towards deep learning. Why deep learning? The thing is going on like quite like a phenomenal approach. But there is silently a growth. I mean, it's like a mutation from the deep learning is what we call as the transformers. So in transformers, it actually started from NLP. So then now we are having some transformers in vision transformers as well, like for the computer vision problems. So that's what I'm going to discuss today. But firstly, we will see about a brief introduction about convolutional neural network and recurrent neural networks. And then we will look into the vision transformers. So fundamentally, we have this artificial intelligence as the huge set, and machine learning has been a subset of AI, and deep learning is still a subset of machine learning itself. So deep learning is like still more refined form of machine learning, as we all can understand. But this artificial intelligence, it started from the year around the 1950s. And it has been for like around 30 years. So you can see this almost these years. What exactly they were doing these days? What kind of breakthroughs happen in the IT and computing? So this actually came into existence after the Second World War. So can anybody say what is the most remarkable achievement in this period of time?
Yeah,
It will be, I can give a clue, like it was around this period. So the man landing on the moon, as well as the space explorations, as well as the satellite launches and the satellite communications, all these were the beginning of this AI. So they have the computer programmed equipments to control these space missions and all those. Even today, if you see the space missions, some of the consoles are still running on the old languages like C and C++. And then there was like a fancy of humanoids in the artificial intelligence era, which started in 1950s. So in this era of artificial intelligence, people started making like machines that can imitate a man, something like that, but not exactly to imitate like a man. Those machines won't think, those are running on the programming. So it will have a list of tasks to perform. So that's what we call as artificial intelligence. And some horoscope also was done using this kind of artificial intelligence mission. You all know that there is one something called as Sivagami Chodida Nilayam. You all like they have like a humanoid robot kind of person, and then they will have some kind of program written in some if and else loops for this particular sign and moon sign. Then this is the prediction like that they used to give. This is like a pre-program, so that machine cannot think by itself. So artificial intelligence main mission is to make the machine to think by itself the same way the humans also think, or to make like a superhuman intelligence. So then we started having this machine learning from 1980s to 2010s. So this is the era where we are quite fascinated towards algorithms like naive Bayes, support vector machine, and so many other technologies have been developed using this kind of machine learning stuff. And for the past one decade, we are having this deep learning. So for deep learning, we need support of some hardwares as well. People say that you can work with the Google Colab for any deep learning task. But the problem is that, be it Google Colab GPU, there that has not the GPU, it has a tensor processing unit. Be it the tensor processing unit of Google Colab or the Tesla Titan TPU, which is present in Kaggle, it can have a lot of limitations unless you go for a paid or like a subscription-based system. You cannot use it for all your applications. But for hassle-free approach, I always recommend the deep learning researchers to go with a dedicated laptop at least. A computer is good because you can rely on its capacity, but at least you need to have a laptop with a GPU. But this is actually the breakthrough since the 2010s, and it has been transforming the systems to a greater level. Now we will see into the architecture of transformer. So this is the transformer architecture. We have the input fed, and it has like around 15-16 steps. It looks like the normal CNN architecture, but it is not CNN. In CNN, we normally stack the layers in the sequential model. So in this sequential model, we keep like, what exactly is like the sequential model? I can say the example, it's like the lace stacks, you know. It has a beautiful packaging, like it has some kind of a polymer-based carton, and then inside that the chips are placed in such a way that it doesn't have a clash with each other, so it stays intact. So just like that is what we call as the sequential stack. Like the same way we used to keep the layers of the convolutional neural network, like be it convolution or max pooling or whatever it is, and even this batch normalization or softmax or all these things we can keep arranging together to make a convolutional neural network. So it goes like in one straight line, but it has no looking back. But some architectures like ResNet, it has something like a feed forward network, which we see over here, but that is not so common. Most of the architectures, if you see right from LenNet and the VGG or even the EfficientNet, it has this kind of sequential aspect. The left one over here, so this particular part is we call as the encoder, and this particular part is we call as decoder. So it has like these two parts. So we see about the encoder, which takes the input sequence, and encoder is much needed to understand the vision transformers. A decoder we don't need to look into for the case of computer vision problems. Actually, like if you are working for a natural language processing, you need to know a lot about these kind of transformers. So this basic transformers, including this encoder and decoder, are much needed for NLP problems. But the inspiration is taken only from this encoder in this architecture, and then it is used for making the vision transformers. So this is what we have seen so far. Now we see that we have the input of image. The image will be fed into the input embedding, and then we will have this encoding, which will give the numbering for each and every part. And then we have this multi-head attention. On top of that, we have this add and adder and the normalization. And then we have this feed network. And after getting into the feed network, it goes into the multi-head attention. So where is the multi-head attention? So we see that here, like we sent the signals into the multi-head attention, and there we have a scaled dot product attention, and they are all concatenated together and made into a linear array. So this is how it looks. And what happens inside the scaled product attention? We have this Q input, K input, and V input. So this Q value and K value are multiplied using matrix, and then they are converted into a scalar, and then they are masked with a vector. Then after that, the output of that is taken as a softmax. So what will be the outcome of softmax? Normally in CNN, we use the softmax. We use the CNN max pooling, and then batch normalization, and then we go for I'm not saying any perfect architecture, but this is how the layers goes. And then we have the fully connected layers, and before going to the fully connected, we have the flattening, and then fully connected, and at last we have this softmax. So what does this softmax do? It gives a probability which ranges between the numbers 0 to 1. So it will be like a decimal value, maybe like 0.7 or 0.8 something. And then this value, this linear value of V, which we feed over here, so that is taken, and that is multiplied with this softmax value. So as many number of classes, as many number of values you will get in the softmax, and it is multiplied by this linear value of V. So that will give the scalar product, and that is concatenated and taken into a linear format. That is how we get the outcome of this transformer. So what exactly happens? That the input data is firstly embedded into a vector. And this embedding layer helps us to grab a vector, which is representation of each word. So this is for the NLP. So we feed the sentences. Normally, if you see the NLP task, we normally do on the large corpus of text information. So when we feed that sentences, they are converted into tokens. And these tokens are each represent a particular value, and these values are embedded as like a vector, like what is the value mapped for each and every word, and then they are combined together and then they are made as a representation for each word. So I think I didn't show you the paper. That's over here. But this is one paper which they made it, like converting this into image words. Like this is what we will discuss later part of this presentation. And actually, like, we divide the image into parts. The text is also divided into parts, and then we use the encoding. So this positional encoding means it will give one numerical value for each and every token which is extracted from the sentence, and then we feed the data into a multi-headed attention. In the multi-headed attention, we see this is what happens. We give the values, the number values, and then they are taken into the scaled dot product. The scaled dot product will do all these operations which I mentioned. So this Q and K, we do the math multiplication, and this is what I explained already. And then we have this kind of scaled dot product attention. So this will give the softmax activation using this function. So for every value of Z, we get a particular value which corresponds to the probability value. And then we get, as I mentioned, we have this probability values ranging between 0 to 1, 0.0 to 0.90. For example, these are all classes, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So the probability of this second class is supposed to be the highest. So this is the class identified. So this is how the classification is done for any data set. So finally, we have this self-attention. So this is all happening in the multi-headed attention. So these are all the processes happening in each and every part of this vision transformer architecture. So now in NLP transformers, we have this Google's BERT, that is a bidirectional encoder representation from transformers. So this is one of the most famous transformers used for NLP tasks. Like this BERT, we have this length adaptive BERT based ES, distal BERT, length adaptive distal BERT, and length adaptive distal BERT ES, and all those. So these are all the different variations. Like, you can even create your own encoder if you are quite fluent into their layered taskings. So in the year 2020, that is almost a year ago, they published a paper called Vision Transformers. And it came into the ArcSU. These ArcSU papers are a preprint, but still they are like published in the top conferences. So they published a paper titled An Image is Worth 16x16 Words, that is the Transformers for Image Recognition. So this was developed by Google Research, and this is inspired from the NLP transformers which we have seen before. Like all these BERT, they took these architectures as an inspiration, and then they developed this vision transformers. So then this has a particular kind of efficacies when compared to the normal deep learning. Of course, the cost of computing for this algorithm is more than the CNN architectures, but the efficiency is like quite convincing. When it comes to the vision transformer, we have only the encoder as we saw in the normal transformers. In the vision transformer, what we are supposed to do, we are dividing the image into chip. For example, here we say that the image is worth 16x16 words. That is, for one image, we divide it into 16x16. That is 16 rows and 16 columns. Like that, we keep splitting the images into smaller tasks. So it comes something like the divide and conquer. So after this image is split into these parts, then we give the numbers. For example, so this is like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And these are added with the linear projections and fed into the transformer encoder. And this transformer encoder is connected to the multi-layer perceptron head. So that's where we have the neural network feeded into that. And this multi-layer perceptron is what we saw in like this multi-headed attention. And then we have this adder and normalization, and then it keeps on going to the layers. And finally, we get the outcome. So the outcome is obtained by the softmax. The last layer in this NLP head is what we call as the softmax. And this will give the probability for that particular data to be a particular class, whether it is a bird or a ball or a car. So that's how you get the outcome for this any classification problem. But this is how the vision transformer also works. If you ask me, like, is VIT, that is the vision transformer, is the only architecture which is available, then I will say no. This is the first transformer architecture which has been developed for the computer vision problems. But recently there has been a survey paper also which circulated in many of the top conferences and even in the top forums and social media. You can search it, like the survey on vision transformer models. So you can search in this way. So that one document, it gives a survey of all the recent advancements, what are the different kinds of transformers done and all those. But still, to implement this, mostly people are using PyTorch. The support is not much available with the Keras. But I can show you a demonstration with the Keras. But the problem is that it has a limitation. I will explain. So I will share you the code as well. So in that case, if you are willing to work, you can work on it. And if you can make it work the way I need, then definitely you can create a lot of potential research outcomes. So this is the graphical representation of how it works. We get the linear projection, and then we are doing the encoding, that is giving the numbering, and then we are feeding to the transformer encoder, and that will give the probability. So this is the way you can understand, like, how it has it works. And then they are using only the encoder part of the NLP transformers, but we are not much concentrated into the decoder part. So we can divide the patches as like you want. Like, we can go for 16 cross 16 or 32 cross 16, depends on the size of the image. So mostly in deep learning, we get like the resource exhausted problem, where we give like a very large amount of data into the CNN's tunnel. So that will not be enough to accommodate everything. So we split the batch size. Likewise, we can divide these patches into as much we want. If you want like more number of patches, we can add more in the windows. And they are then processed and flattened and then sent into the further processing into the network. So this is the sample coding which you can see. So this uses the Keras sequential model. And then we are, firstly, how we are processing. We are using the normalization on the images. And then we are resizing the image size. For example, here we have like 16 cross 16. Then the image size we have to declare like image underscore size equal to 16. This is how you have to set. and then it goes into the horizontal flipping, and then it takes a random rotation factor of 0.02, and then we go for the random zoom. So unlike the normal neural networks, we have a model that has no idea where the position of samples go on. We sample each and every patch from the input image, and then they are positioned into the vector and fed into the encoder. So finally, we get the softmax based output in the form of vector, but they are also having a special token like the BERT, the bidirectional transformer in NLP. So same like the NLP transformers, here also we have this embedded patches which goes into the normalization, and then the multi-head attention the same way, and then they are subjected to adder. So this is the adder, and then we have this normalization, and then this goes into the multi-level perceptron. We have the difference that we have a decoder from the output and the encoder from the input, and so it goes like in the form of the feed forward neural network into the MLP. When we compare the performance of this VIT against all the other CNN algorithms, because since this is the first transformers that the performance comparison was done based on the performance given by other CNN algorithms. So if we can see the performance on the ImageNet database, ResNet architecture, the variation of ResNet is like coming around 80 plus, that is the highest one. But when you take the VIT, it is having at least a 5% in the increase in the performance of classification accuracy. So this is how the ImageNet performance proves that the algorithm is quite good when you use for this vision transformers. But the problem is that they are using something called a CIFAR dataset for the implementation in Keras. So here you can see the comparison. So with the various versions, like when we have the vision transformers of window size of 14, window size of 16. So like we have this VATH and VATL. So VATL is the vision transformer, and VATH is a previous version of this VAT. And then we use this 16 window, so that gives a best of the performance. And then they have like a ResNet based transformer that is also having a competing accuracy. So most of these transformers in for computer vision are doing much better than the convolutional neural network architectures which are available nowadays. So we have a source code I have posted. Let me share that one. So I share the source code from my GitHub. I just found it from internet. And then I tried in my own visual code. So for implementing this vision transformers, what they have done is they have imported something called as TensorFlow add-ons. So this is much needed. In addition to the normal CNN, we import NumPy TensorFlow, and then we import Keras, and then import the layers, all those we will import normally for a CNN architecture. But this TensorFlow add-ons is added new. And then we set like number of classes and the input size 32. So it will divide it into like 32 cross 32. And then we load this CIFAR dataset. What I need is this part. Actually, I want this transformer to work like we have our own custom data set stored in the folders, and then we can take the data and feed it into the vision transformer, which we have it over here, and then get the outcome. But the CIFAR data set, how it looks like, it is actually an image data set, but it will be in the form of Excel sheet. It will be an Excel sheet having a huge capacity. So the small miniature version of those images are fit into that Excel sheet, and that's how the data is read. But when we have the custom data set or like your own data set, it is practically impossible to get it implemented. So though these vision transformers are showing benchmark standards higher than the CNNs, it still needs to work with the custom data sets. So that is one of the research problems available right now. So in case if you can work on it, you are most welcome. Actually, like there are some systems which work with the PyTorch, but Keras is not having much resources to facilitate this architecture. The reason why we need Keras is that usage of Keras is quite predominant, not only among the developers, but also those enthusiasts who needs to develop something with the deep learning. So it has a wider usage in the technical community. So that's the reason why I always look for the code to load the files directly, not like importing this kind of Keras data sets. So then we can see the data augmentation, that is the input form. Firstly, we do the normalization. Then we are resizing the image. What is the image underscore size? See, we have set it like 72 over here. So it divides like 72 columns and 72 rows. And then we are flipping it horizontal. And then we fit into a random rotation factor of 0.02. And then we set all these parameters and then send in the images. So this is the code block which makes the images into patches. So those patches are done with the image processing. And then this is the VAT model, which has the VAT classifier. And then we have the transformer layers. So all those layers, we have the layer normalization, multi-head attention. So this multi-head attention is another function. So here we have the multi-level perceptron function, which is called over here for getting the features. And finally, we use the dense layer to get the output, like the probability values. And then we have the code for compiling and running the code. And finally, we get the outcome. So this outcome will give like the training, testing, and validation accuracy. So you can take a look on this code, which I have shared with you. In case if you can work on it, it will be like definitely useful for the research community. So that's all about transformers. So I'm done with it. So I have shared the link of the transformers from my GitHub in this chat box. So anybody interested can take it and try to implement. So it's a good one for doing a final year project, or like if you want to do some quality research and to get some challenging results, then I believe that transformer is one among that. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, sir, for giving us some extra exposure about transformers, artificial intelligence, and many more. We would like to have you amongst us often to gain more knowledge, sir. And I sincerely appreciate you for making time for us in your busy schedule to give extra knowledge to us and accepting our request to talk to us today. I thank you again, sir. I would also like to thank Dr. Alry Jovan, sir, for giving us a wonderful introduction about our chief guest of the day. The best teachers give you the answer. They spark within you the desire to find yourself. Now, I call upon Hariharan, sir, to give the vote of thanks.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Wonder, present here. It's my privilege to present a vote of thanks in this gracious occasion. I, on behalf of the Advanced Theoretics Cluster, extend a very heartfelt thanks to Dr. Ferdinand Joe John Joseph, who readily accepted our invitation in spite of his busy schedule, spent his valuable time and shared his ideas, views on artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning. I express my gratitude to our principal, Dr. M. Paul Raj, for providing encouragement, support, and motivate us to conduct this kind of events. I also thank our head of the department, Dr. M. Suresh Kumar, for his guidance and support. As no program can become successful from a single person, so I extend my thanks to our department colleagues, staffs, and students for this process, for their contribution. Once again, I thank you all for making this event a grand success. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for giving a wonderful
time to the function. Build your life on your dreams, because dreams never have bad endings. It's time to bid adieu to all the staff, students, HODs, and speakers who took part in this inauguration function today. Thank you once again and have a great evening. Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you. So see you all.
Thank you, Ferdinand.
Yeah, I'll take a leave.